Joan Ferguson?
We're holding a wake for Slasher. And it's at your place, Freak. You got a nice place here, Freak. Everything but an open fire. And we're gonna fix that up right now.
You see, we're gonna let you go. Because you're never gonna have another peaceful day as long as you live. You cross me ever again. And I'll let the gang know you fixed it for Slasher. And then wherever you are, they'll find you. You're gonna be dead meat, Ferguson. After they've had their fun.
Mrs. Ryan, Joan Ferguson. About your offer. Up it to 12,000 and I'll consider. Don't worry. Egbert's got no hope.
Don't you cry, darling. Mummy's going away to the Wicked King's dungeons. It's only for a little while. And you know what? If the Pale Fairy is good to her, she could be back this afternoon.
I wouldn't count too much on the Pale Fairy for you.
You never know. Could be a happy ending.
I've heard through my sources that Connors and her gang aren't your favourite people. They're not mine either. And I have decided that between the two of us, we're going to get rid of them once and for all.
Us against Connors? You must be joking.
I've never been more serious.
Then you're barking up the wrong tree. You're the last person I need help from.
And how far do you think you'll get with half-wits like Williams to back you up?
Don't worry, I'll succeed.
With what? You don't think that piddling little cache of weapons you've got is going to protect against Connors, do you?
What are you talking about?
And don't you come the innocent with me, Maxwell. If you don't cooperate, the governor will be the first one to find them. Then Williams will be off to Blackmore and you'll be here all alone, very vulnerable.
Let me go and we'll talk.
That's better.
How did you know about the weapons?
None of your business. But you can be damn sure that no one so much as hiccups in this place that I don't find out about it.
All right. What do you want us to do?
Oh, not us, Max. You. I want Connors destroyed, and I don't want anyone to know that I'm firing the bullets, especially Williams. Is that clear?
Oh, very. I do all the dirty work, and you get all the benefits. Thanks, but I'd rather take my chances without you.
You'll do it. Because as long as Connors is around, your life will be hell. Now, you help me and I'll back you up. You don't, and you're as good as dead.
Oh, sorry.
And you can do that punishment right now. What are you doing in here?
I'm getting something. Is that a crime?
You watch your mouth or you'll be on a charge too. Out.
Hey, Reet's in a real good mood today. I wonder why.
Well, you'll probably get just as bored doing this, Nance.
Yeah, about the only exciting thing to do in here is watch the washing go round.
Beats counting spots on the wall, Alice, and it's great to have someone to talk to.
Well, it's good having you, Nance. We just about got the whole gang in here now.
Mm. Yeah. Hey, where's Lex got to? That's the last load in there.
Well, she only had maternity to pick up.
Little bugger better not be catching up on lost sleep.
Hey, maybe she tried and she got sprung.
No, they just sent her back here. Only the freak could drag her off to Reno. And I don't think she's in the mood for heavying anyone today.
Yeah. Still can't get over it. We finally got her where we want her. Hey, we could get her to bring in goodies and everything.
No way, sister.
Why not?
We push her too far, she'll figure she's got nothing to lose.
But you said if she tried anything...
No buts.
We got her where we want her, and we're going to keep her there.
So everyone spread the word. No one does anything unless they tell me about it first.
Jeez, I'm not about to try and get her.
Just a minute, just a minute. What was that, Lurch?
Nothing.
You've got to grumble, you air it. We're a gang, remember?
Right. I think it stinks. That bitch has been riding us for years. Now we've got a chance to get our own back. You put the stoppers on
for a bloody good reason. Listen, we all start putting the boot in, the screws are going to notice something's up.
Yeah? So we're not going to kick her every time we walk past. Just get her to bring some stuff.
No!
Now shut it. Jeez, Ray!
Alice, no, she's right.
Come on, love, see reason. You got what you wanted last night, and thank God you weren't caught.
Hey, you bludgers, guess what? Send Mabel, she came for a visit.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, no, okay. Jess is better than she's ever been. She sends her love. Oh. And guess what? Podcast preggers.
Oh. I hope you haven't got that the wrong way round.
No, but that's not all. Jess has organised a special treat for us all.
You beauty. Hey, a party with all the trim and
oh, no, don't be fancy. Oh, shut up, the body.
All right, a bit of sugar.
Well, what is it then?
Look, honest, I don't know. Mabel didn't say. But she told me I had to tell you all that we had to be at the top area after work this arvo. Reckons we're going to see something that's going to drive us wild, especially the screws.
Jeez, hey!
Right, Maxwell, anyone comes in, you start tidying up this mess.
Connors and company have something on you, don't they?
They think they do, and that's the way I like to keep it.
And why me? You don't know you can trust me.
Self-interest is a great motivator, Maxwell. You have as much to gain by bringing Connors down as I do. And much more to lose.
All right. But I won't pretend I like it.
You are learning, aren't you? To survive in here, you play the game.
When do you plan to start this little campaign?
Right now. There's a small problem to be taken care of before we go for the big fish. Should be simple enough, even for you. Julie Egbert.
Well, maybe she's going to make a drop or something.
Mm. What? Chocolate frogs?
Well, she wouldn't throw drugs in. She's dead against it.
No.
Could be booze.
Oh, maybe. Not after Julie lost her parole because of it.
No, look, it's going to be something way over the top the way Mabel was carrying on.
Well, maybe she's going to parachute in.
What?
Well, it's up in the top area, isn't it? Well, she could land a plane up there if she wanted to.
Yeah, massive escape. Good one, Lurch.
Oh, no, Jessie, that'll be the last thing we think of.
A little less noise, please, ladies. Egbert, you've got a visitor.
Steve?
Whoa! Right, that's enough. Are we going to get another handyman, Mrs. M?
Back to work, Jenkins.
Oh, boy, you got a bad lurch.
Also a stroke of Nancy's poster last
night. What? And I was just sticking the corner back on.
Yeah, sure.
A bit of all right, but... Geez, Nance, I don't know how you can sleep with him looking at you like that.
I manage.
It's me has the problem.
Hey, Nance, how about we take the camera out and film Jessie's surprise?
Oh, what a good idea.
And anyone who misses it can watch the tape later on.
Yeah.
You ought to hear what she's cooking up now.
What?
Well, it's about this idea of a documentary on life inside.
Oh, that's easy. You walk around the dump pointing the camera.
Oh, pretty boring, but...
Exactly. Now, I thought we could write a little script, you know, a sort of narrative, tie the whole thing together and plan the whole thing as a day in the life.
Look out, Steven Spielberg. Oh.
And do you think we'd get hold of any officer's uniform?
Oh. Hey, Bag's doing the freak. So, if you don't let me, you're all on a charge. And I want a cut of the profits, and you can get down and lick up that floor. It's disgusting.
Good eye, Miss Ferguson. Rotten bugger!
She was really friendly, Steve. You know, I thought she'd look down her nose at me, but she didn't at all.
Well, then you didn't meet the real Amy. I'm sorry, Julie, but Mother's a snob. Well, she won't even talk to the gardener if she can avoid it.
Well, why come and see me then?
Oh, I wish I knew.
Look, she probably just wanted to meet me. That'd be natural, wouldn't it? Meet the girl your son's going to marry?
If your family made who's who, then I'd believe it.
Oh, don't joke. She was friendly, honest. I'm sure she liked me.
Believe me, Julie, you can't take her at face value. Oh, she can be pretty devious at times, and I've got a horrible feeling this is one of them.
Well, I don't know. I thought...
Look, well, she probably won't ever come out here again, but if she does, just... Well... Be careful.
You make it sound awful.
I don't mean to. The thing is, she's terrified of being left on her own. She'll do anything to stop that happening.
But why? She's got you and your sisters. Even when you all get married, she'd still see you.
I wish she could see it that way. Well, ever since Dad died, she's relied on us to fill the gap. She can't stand the thought of any of us leaving.
Is that why you still live there, even though she's...
Yeah. But I'm not going to let that situation interfere with us. She is just going to have to cope. That's all there is to it.
You sure she'll be all right?
But right now, I'm more concerned about you.
Oh, I'm great. I just wish it was 5.5 months from now.
Oh, yes, so do I.
Sheets. Lurch, give Jules and Nance a hand.
Oh, sorry.
One put the stuff in the bags in one time.
Right, hold it open for us, Lurch.
Hey, quick! Miss Hagen says it's 4:25.
We're hurrying.
It took you so long.
Oh, I got stuck at the bloody gates. You yelled myself stupid.
You said it, sister.
Oh, look, it wasn't funny. I thought I was going to miss out on the surprise.
Everyone get the word?
Yep, except all the usual nerds and wimps. Hey, Nance, as soon as the bell goes, you go get the camera, okay?
Yeah, we'll do.
A comic. Right. Visitor.
Me?
Oh, no.
Well, who is it, Miss Ferguson?
You have a problem, Patterson.
No, Miss Ferguson.
How about you? Life treating you okay?
Watch it, Connors. McCormick, move it.
Oh, bloody hell, what are we going to do now?
So you take the pics. You're always the one bags and being director.
Yeah, but that's just saying what to do. I mean, what if I stuff it up?
Just remember what Nancy showed us.
Come on, let's just see if the old Jess has got for it.
Yeah!
I wouldn't have a clue. Have you organised the coke yet?
Bitch hasn't turned up yet. Break her arm if she pikes. What the freak want you for?
Nothing important.
I heard you copped extra punishment.
She didn't like the way I held my mouth, all right?
All right, oh. What's up you?
Oh, there you are, Williams. Come along, your sister's here to see you.
Oh, beauty. See you, Kath. I'll say good day to her for you. The top area, get in shape.
Fine, but I don't want things getting out of hand.
Well, I'm not into running. I think I'll give it a miss.
Oh, no, you don't.
What's the hold up?
Are we allowed up there?
You have to wait for Mrs. Morris.
Oh, no, we won't go mucking around on us, Mrs. Pringle. We're wasting time.
You're not usually this anxious for exercise.
Well, it's the gym. We're really into getting fit. Oh, there's nothing like a bit of running to top it off, eh?
Yeah!
Hey,
the plane, look!
And where?
Oh, look!
Oh, Jenkins, come here. Seem to have got this jogging bug.
Come on.
Slow down, ladies.
Oh, yeah. And Patsy's up in Mullewa. Got 2 years.
Oh, no. What for?
Silly twerp was trying to flog all this hot stuff. Some junkies loaded on her.
What about Morp? He ever talk about me?
Now and again. Wouldn't hold my breath if you're expecting him to come visit, but... What's she doing in here? Robbing milk money or something?
Doing in her old man. Don't know who the spunk is.
There you are. Oh, Peter, so lovely to see you.
You too, ma'am.
Oh, don't worry. They're not so fussy about contact in here. Sit down.
I thought you might have been mad about me coming.
No. And how are you, Peter? I mean, is everything all right? You keeping busy?
Yeah. Took a while. Well, I don't know, ma'am. I just keep thinking about you being here.
No, let's not discuss that.
Yeah. I'm handling it okay now. I just wish your case would come up so we could get you back home again.
Me too. Hope they won't be too hard on me. Mm. Oh, but what's this we? Is Harry back home?
No, that's the reason I came. To tell you about Danielle. She wants to meet you.
Danielle?
Yeah, I met her at uni. I'm going to ask her to marry me.
Peter... Oh, that's wonderful, darling. But does she know what's happened?
No, I'll tell her eventually. Well, after the trial, maybe. Huh?
Well, you have to tell her, darling, no matter what happens. Anyway, you tell me, how's uni? You're doing exams now.
Never seems to end. You just finish one lot and you have to swat up for the next. I managed a few credits, though.
Oh, get stuck.
What the hell, Sandy? Do you want to get kicked out?
Is that what you dragged me in here for? To ask me to get dope in?
Keep it down, will you? Jeez. Look, it's not just that. Hell, I haven't seen you in yonks.
Yeah, well, forget the coke. I'm not going to risk ending up in this hole.
Well, I wouldn't have asked you. I know I've got to buy some protection. You know what it's like in these dumps.
No, I don't, and that's just how I like it. Anyway, knowing you, you're lying your head off. Probably just want to flog it yourself.
I'm not honest. Look, I'm having a rough trot. I've got to have it to get them off me back.
Yeah, well, I'd like to help you, but no way. Hell, Jan, what if I got caught smuggling it in?
Oh, well, get stuffed, selfish bitch!
Oh, Jan!
Well, I hate the thought of you being in here with women like her.
Oh, well, you can't avoid them. There's some good ones, though. I've made some wonderful friends in here. Anyway, you'll read it all in my diary.
I'm glad to see it's not getting you down, ma'am. It's been worrying me like crazy.
Yes, I know. Perhaps it was a mistake asking you not to come here.
Yeah, well, I couldn't. Not any longer.
Oh, darling, so good to see you. And to know how well you're doing. And you tell Danielle... I'd love to meet her.
First chance I get.
Oh, God, it's killing me.
Yeah, yeah. I wish I knew where to look.
So where's this big surprise?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe we're looking in the wrong place.
We checked right along the fence. Nothing.
Lurch is still looking for Sanders' plane to land.
Oh, shut up, will ya?
Hey, maybe that's it. Doesn't look like much. Hey, wonder what he's doing.
Oh, he's probably just come to perv on us. Hey, gorgeous!
To save his skin. Just wait till she wants something, stinking bitch.
It was a flat no?
As good as. Scared she'd get nabbed when they frisked her. Hell, what are we gonna do now? We promised Deb Coke. The only one we've talked around, and we're gonna lose her.
Don't worry, I'll get someone else to bring it in.
Who? You got contacts out there?
No, but well, I'm sure Alan could bring it in if your sister supplied it. Would she be in that?
Yeah. Thought you said your old man was going to Perth.
I'll get him to put it off.
Have to talk good. He's straight, isn't he?
Don't you worry about that side of it. The coke will get here. I guarantee it. Coffee?
Yeah, ta. Full of surprises, eh?
Trust Jessie. Joyce's face was a picture. She didn't know where to look.
Oh, it's a good thing Joan wasn't there. She'd have burst a blood vessel.
Oh, I'll say. And no amount of orders would have brought them back from that fence, believe me. Well, I better get on with it. Just thought you'd like to know how the exercise period went.
Yes, and you can tell the women I think their sudden interest in jogging is a wonderful idea. We'll introduce it on a permanent basis.
I'll break out the riot gear first.
Oh, Miss Ferguson. See you later.
Yes, Miss Ferguson.
I suppose you've heard about that disgusting display outside the prison grounds?
Yes, I did. Seems to have boosted morale no end.
And at what cost? It was a total breach of prison discipline, and I don't just mean the women.
There was no harm done.
How can we be sure of that? The officers did nothing to stop it. Joined in the party, from what I heard.
Don't you think you're overreacting to some harmless fun?
Oh, come on. It was a deliberate ruse to draw attention away from another area. God knows what's been smuggled in this time.
All right, if you're so convinced, why don't you bring me some evidence?
I'll check with my source. If contraband has found its way in, you can be sure the minister will find out about it.
I'll sign the report myself. And while we're on the subject, don't you think it's time you stop playing Mickey Spillane and let us know who this source is? Once the women find out who's been informing on them, she'll need protection.
You don't need to worry. This is one source that won't be hung from the rafters.
And so they took her onto the roof and subjected her to a most terrifying ordeal. The woman probably wouldn't think twice about subjecting one of us to the same treatment. But does this justify their actions? Oh, Miss Ferguson.
I was told that one of these dorms had a blocked basin.
Oh, I don't think so. Why did you...
I told you why I was here, McCormick. Prisoners do not question officers in future. Remember that. Right, Maxwell, I want to know what that nonsense outside the fence was for.
You haven't a clue.
Don't give me that. It had to be a cover-up.
Look, it was just a strip show from what I heard. Anyway, our deal had nothing to do with me turning informer. Let's stick to business. There are a couple of things I need from you.
Such as?
Muscle and cocaine.
Ugh. You can forget the cocaine. Because I'm not doing anything that can be traced back to me. The muscle you have to find for yourself.
Look, I can destroy Connors. If we get someone in here who's a match for her, there must be someone in another block you could get transferred. The cocaine is to buy the extra backing we'll need to make sure Connors stays down.
You can forget the drugs. You have to think of something else.
Too late. Everything's been organized, including the payoffs. We mightn't get another chance if we let this one go. Here's the supplier.
Williams?
Janet's sister. Don't worry, all Janet knows is that I'm arranging for someone to get it.
Well, what about the money? Stuff like that doesn't come cheap.
You know prisoners aren't allowed cash. Call it an investment for the future. Your future.
Very smart, Maxwell. But you're forgetting one thing. Egbert. She's still one of the conditions.
Plant some cocaine in a cell. Should be enough.
It's too simple. She's got to be caught red-handed. This, Williams. Would she have supplies of LSD?
I'm sure she would.
She hoped you liked the budget Rena truck up with
that. You're not half a mile away. What's happening?
They're still celebrating Jessie's surprise.
Hey, where's Auntie Ida? I thought you were going to bring her to see the tape.
She's still snoring her head off.
Oh, that's okay. We can show it to Nancy now and then show it again later.
Yeah. Hang on, it's my tape and I say what goes.
Oh, what? What'd you listen to?
Oh, get stuffed. I did all the hard work and I say when it's shown. It'll cost you a buck each to see it.
Oh,
there, you great hulk.
You're going to take a cake, sister. More hide than a Brahmin ball.
Oh, free enterprise. That's okay, Anna. It was a present to all of us. You can't charge. Only the strip in the flesh was. Not my tape. Ella zoomed in all the right places, and now it's worth paying for.
You did?
Patterson's pornographic peep show. What do you reckon?
Oh, well, I'll have one, but it's got to be in the front row. No worries.
Yeah.
You don't look too unhappy about missing it.
Peter came.
True.
Oh, Julie, it was so good to see him again. He's got a girl now, you know. He's even talking about getting married.
Oh, that's fantastic. No wonder you're letting all this go over your head.
I think I might sneak off for a while. I'd like to be on my own for a bit.
Okay, I'll catch you at 10.
Now, if you lose your tickets, you don't get in. Anyone else want one?
It's like going through a dragon's dungeon with a huge trove of treasure at the end of the tunnel.
Just concrete and bars, Wilkinson.
Don't be so practical. Use your imagination.
Hello there.
Wilkinson. Lorelei.
Just call me Laurie. It's more friendly.
Oh, let's just stick to your official name, shall we? Right, come down here and stand on the white line.
Everyone's being so boring and formal.
Well, you better get used to it. Mm. Your name is Lorelei Wilkinson.
That's only one of them. Pardon? Sometimes I use other names. Samantha Damone, Cindy Barber. I love that one. Exotic. Sounds like something out of Arabian Nights.
Aliases.
I like to think of them as characters, each with their own little story.
You've been charged with theft and impersonating police officers.
That's not completely true.
Whether it is or not.
I was wearing plain clothes. I never wore a uniform once. Not that I don't like uniforms.
Just let me finish.
All I did was tell a few jewelers that their employees were ripping them off, replacing diamonds with imitations.
And stealing some behind their backs.
Only a few.
So the answer's yes.
Pardon?
Your name is Lorelei Wilkinson. You've been charged with theft and impersonating a police officer.
Well, if you want to put it like that. Yes.
Be held on remand until such time as you're brought to trial. Is that correct?
So ironic. I was just about to get my own engagement ring, too. Such a lovely man.
Should have thought of that before you stole the diamonds.
I'll leave you to it.
Right, come over here. We'll check your suitcase and your handbag.
Do you like Tabitha Morelli? Very Mediterranean, I always thought.
Just empty your handbag.
You're the slickin' bitch.
Well, I asked some of the other girls just to make sure. Nobody knew anything about a block drain, leaking tap, or anything like that.
What's with the happy faces?
Tell them this. I was just saying, I caught Miss Ferguson snooping around in my cell.
Our cell? What was she doing then?
She's just in, I don't know. Just looking, I suppose.
Frigg doesn't just look. She's up to something. I'll bet me last buck on. Could be testing us.
Planting something, maybe.
Yeah. As soon as we've finished here, we go and search the cell, every square inch of it.
Them two girls are thick, aren't
they? Yeah.
Enjoy each other's stink, that's all. Do you reckon they're up to something, Ruth?
What, those two? Nah. A couple of mozzies need swatting every now and then.
I thought you were the man who never heard. I phoned his sister. She's organising it. It's got nothing to do with him.
Good one. You're a bit of a dark horse, aren't you?
I'd have thought all your friends on the outside were straight. If I didn't know you better. Mind your own business. Just make sure the women know about the coke coming in.
Sure, no need to bite me bloody head off.
Sandy know about the picker? She will.
Ah, and one eyeliner.
That's all.
Girl can't have enough makeup these days. You never know what young man might be to... Well, I don't suppose I'll have any need for it.
Well, it'll all have to be checked, but since you're on remand, I see no reason...
I can have it back.
That'll be up to the governor.
Oh.
In the meantime, we're to get you showered. So we just come this way, please.
All right, I'm off now.
Hello, Joan.
What's she doing here?
New arrival. Why?
Thought you were on the straight and narrow.
Okay, Sarah. Nice to see a friendly face, though.
Go through to the showers, will you? There's a towel in there. I'll be there in a minute. What's going on? Do you know her?
Yeah. She was an inmate at the prison I worked at in Queensland.
See?
Oh, she's just a minor offender. Shoplifting. Runs off at the mouth a bit, but she's harmless enough. Be a good thing if it rubbed off on some of the scum in here.
Is that you, Joan?
Yeah.
Well, what do you think?
It's lovely. What's the occasion?
Just thought you'd appreciate it, that's all.
Oh, you shouldn't have gone to so much trouble.
Nonsense. 16-hour shift after what you've been through, it's the least I can do. Now, why don't you go inside and sit down, and I'll get us a drink.
Thanks.
Scotch?
Oh, please.
Have you heard when the insurance will be coming through?
It won't. The person I used to live with forgot to post the premium.
He forgot?
My fault for not reminding him, I suppose.
Yeah. Well, you mustn't blame yourself. Here you are.
Thank you. Oh, there's a couple at work have offered me a place to stay,
Oh, you're more than welcome to stay here, Joan. Besides, I enjoy your company.
Yeah, but I'm putting you to so much trouble.
No, no, look, really, I like it. And besides, you did say you like to leave your work behind you when you relax. There'll be no shop talk here, Joan, not unless you want to.
Thank you. The good news is that I might be coming into some money from elsewhere.
Yeah? Really? That's terrific. Well, here's to better times, then. That'll be the roast.
Yes, I'm a friend of your sister, Janet. I believe you can help me.
I can't find anything. I've checked everywhere.
Yeah, nothing. Maybe you were right, Jules. Maybe she was just checking us out.
Yeah.
Hey, what's going on here? Oh, Nance just lost her Bible. We were just helping her look for it.
Yeah.
Patterson, Egbert, this is your new cellmate, Lorelei Wilkinson.
Hello, Lorelei.
Laurie,
How's it going?
Well, Rita Connors.
Oh, she's top dog.
You'd have to be at that altitude.
Cheeky little bugger, isn't she?
I'm Nancy. This is Alice.
Oh, g'day, Laurie.
Hello. Lovely to meet you all.
Right, I, Wilkinson. We'll get you settled in. Come on.
Yeah, me and Lex will come with you.
What?
Oh,
good idea.
Well,
I'm glad if you can tidy up this place. I'll come back before lock up to check it.
Yeah. Hey, nice enough. Sheila, hey.
Last time anyone cracked a tall joke, she ended up flat on her back.
Sounds like she'll be a breath of fresh air.
Oh, sorry, I didn't mean to wake you.
Goodness, I dozed off.
Look, why don't you go to bed? You look done in.
No, I'm waiting for a friend to drop something off. Oh, that'll be them now.
Well, stay there. I'll get a phone.
No, please. I wouldn't mind having a word with them, actually.
Oh, well, why don't you ask them in and I'll make some coffee?
Well, they said something about not keeping the babysitter waiting. I won't be a minute.
Joan Ferguson?
Yes.
Mind if I ask you a few questions?
Oh, hello there. Glad you decided to drop in. My name's Andrew.
Detective Harris, License Court. Oh. We're here to ask Miss Ferguson about the fire that destroyed our house.
Oh, I see.
Would you like some coffee or something?
No, thanks. Won't keep you long. Just want to check up on a few points.
Well, would you excuse us for a minute? Listen, would you mind if I speak to them alone for a while? It's hard enough talking about it as it is.
Yeah, well, you're sure I can't do anything to help?
No, I'll be all right.
Okay, now don't forget to remind them about that telephone call.
No, I'll make sure of it. Well, I'm sorry to keep you waiting. What was it you wanted to know?
We finished investigations at the site of the fire. It looks like it was deliberately lit. I was wondering if you had any idea who might have done it. Held a grudge against you, that sort of thing.
Oh, look, I'm a prison officer and, you know, naturally there are people who would like to see something like this happen to me.
Anybody in particular? Someone who's just been let out recently or still inside with contacts on the outside?
No one I can think of.
We'll check it anyway. And what about threats, intimidating phone calls, anything like that?
No. I wish I could be of more help. It's all been such a nightmare.
Fair enough. What about your friend Andrew? Do you think he could help us?
Oh, no. He's just a friend who's been kind enough to put me up.
I see. We don't seem to be getting very far, do we? I think the best thing we can do is go back over your movements from a week or so ago. See if it helps you recall a detail or two that'll give us something concrete to go on.
What do you think you're doing?
Putting up curtains.
Aye? Putting up curtains. Look, are you out of your tree or something? This is a bloody jail. It's not the Hilton.
Ah, what was once a dungeon may still be a palace. Haven't you read Rapunzel?
Rapunzel? Who's he?
It's a fairy tale. Mm-hmm. Mind giving me a hand to measure the window?
I'll do it. Yeah, well, I think you're out of your tree, bloody cutting up a dress to make curtains.
It's awful without them.
I reckon they're going to be nice.
Not as nice as the ones Granny used to make.
Who's Granny, or is she a fairy tale too?
She's my mum, actually. I call her Gran. She takes care of little Zoe.
Have you got a kid?
Just a year old. I really miss her. But she's in good hands. I mean, that's the main thing.
Lex is going to have a baby soon, aren't you, Lex?
Yeah. Oh, terrific! Oh, you don't know how lucky you are.
Yes, so they keep telling me.
Look, you leave it to me. I've got a wonderful idea. We can turn this whole room into a nursery.
Oh, yeah, well, I don't...
We can put the bassinet over there, and we can put the twist... Hello, I'm Laurie.
What are you two doing here? Take your pong somewhere else.
You're playing screw now, Patterson.
I just wanted to meet them.
They're not worth talking to. They're pox.
Not too bloody sociable yourself.
Oh, well, I'm very glad you've got the message. Now, rack off!
Sorry, I couldn't have been of more help.
Well, if you think of anything, anything at all, here's where I may be contacted.
Thank you. Good night.
Oh, I thought I heard him go. What do they say? Any leads in the culprit?
Nah, not as yet. I told them some names, not that it'll do much good. Anyone that professional's bound to have an alibi.
Mm. Well, I'm going to bed. Why don't you take your mind off it and do the same thing, eh? See you in the morning.
Good night.
Good night.
Hello, Amy Ryan speaking.
Mrs. Ryan, Joan Ferguson. I think I can have your little problem solved tomorrow.
Oh, so soon. I really wasn't expecting it.
I can give you my bank account number now, if you like.
Right, I've got a pen. Okay. Good. I'll get onto that right away. Bye.
Hang on, where's your ticket?
You know I paid you.
Yeah, but how do I know you didn't give it to some other bugger?
Were you going to wait for Ide? She wants to see you too.
Oh, no way. I've got a room full of bloody patrons. They'll throttle me if I don't start it soon.
Oh, come on, Lex. Roll the tie.
Hey, keep your shirt on. See what I mean? Look, I'll give her a private show later, OK?
Yeah.
Hey, where do you think you're going?
Well, this is the recreation room, isn't it?
Not while I'm showing the video, it's not.
Oh, well, I don't want to watch the video. I just want to read a magazine.
No ticket, no entry.
What's going on?
Hasn't got a ticket.
I heard her say she doesn't want to see it.
Yeah, but how do I know she's not going to take a peek? It's not fair the others who pay.
Lexi, I have no intention of looking at it. Ever heard Nance tell a lie?
Yeah, well, as long as you keep your back to the screen.
Good bit of PR never hurt anyone.
So?
What happened when he took them off?
Oh, they went wild. Especially when he came down to us at the table.
Hey, do girls really go to places like that to see male strippers?
They certainly do. You'd be surprised how many of them are married, too.
Oh, geez, it's the first place I'm going, Chook, when I get out of here. Hey, come on. We want spunk.
We want spunk.
Oh, shut up, the lot of you. The screws will be here, then you won't see anyone.
Oh, just get on.
Put it on, then.
Six stars, the lot of you.
Humpty Dumpty sat on the wall. Humpty
hello.
Dumpty had...
Oh, hello. You're Kath, aren't you?
Janet, I'm Kath.
Oh, wasn't very nice the way they treated you last night.
No, well, that's what we came in to talk to you about. The way Rita's creating a little clique around herself, excluding everybody else. Thing is, if you join us, you'll be on the winning side. We're looking for help to undermine them. Make things fair for everybody, including you.
Sorry, I don't take sides. I like everyone. Listen, what do you think of this for curtains? Maybe it might be a little bit somber for up there in the...
That dizzy act isn't going to fool anyone.
Pardon?
Useless wimp. Just don't go sucking up to that lot or else.
What's the or else?
This for starters.
Sorry. I should have warned you. It's a reflex action. It comes from years of defence courses. Well, you have to watch yourself these days with so many strange men about.
Come on up, you kids.
Rack off!
Well, I only want
you haven't heard the last of this, bitch!
Oh, watch where you're going!
You all right? Yes, why shouldn't I be?
Look, you want to stay away from those two. Leave them to read, eh?
Don't worry. I'll be careful.
She's a judo expert. That's all we bloody need.
Yeah, she's not bad.
Bitch.
Williams, shouldn't you be on your way to breakfast?
Oh, fair go.
Don't argue, just move. And you, Maxwell, your cell's a pigsty. Get and clean it up. All right, here it is.
It's not a bad quantity.
Yes, it includes the little surprise for Egbert. Enough acid to knock out an elephant.
When?
Today.
Today?
I want Egbert fixed today.
It's as good as done. To the salt mines. Word has it you two are going to join the workforce.
Yes. Is that a sewing machine?
Last time I looked, yeah.
Oh.
Okay, fire. Give your hand.
Yeah, sure. I don't know what you want to work for, though.
Well, anything would be better than looking at old Sal.
Maxwell.
She's smiled her face and quit.
Yeah.
Oh, it's perfect.
You got a license to drive that thing?
You don't need a license, just a good imagination. Do you mind if I use it?
Yeah, sure. Go for it.
Oh, thanks.
I'll have these curtains finished in no time.
Julie told me about the curtains. I think it's a wonderful idea.
Thanks. I thought I might try pillow slips next.
Yeah, well, how about some doilies for our next tea party, eh, girls?
That's not a bad idea.
All right, girls. Before we get back to work, I reckon Roach here ought to get what's coming to her.
Yeah. Hey, look, well, I haven't done nothing.
Lurch!
What's going on?
Time you got to be one of us, sister. I reckon this makes it official.
It's me colours!
Congratulations, warrior. Let's hear it, girls! Yes! Goes on your notice board, high and proud.
Yeah, too right. Hey, Chook, I'm all out of dirties.
Oh, gee, I'm sorry. I was getting all carried away. Good on ya.
Julie.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Morris, I didn't see you.
You seem very bright today.
Yeah, I'm having a good day, I guess.
How are things going between you and Steve?
Oh, good. Really good. His mum seems to like me too.
I'm glad to hear it. Can't tell you what a pleasant change it is to see things going right for someone.
Excuse me, Governor.
It's all right, Miss Ferguson. No need to knock.
I've just come from C Block. Bit of trouble up there. Merle Jones.
Oh?
Seems one of the women called her by her nickname, Loony. She reacted by smashing up two dorms and half of their rec room.
I've told Dr. Weissman she doesn't belong here. She should be in an institution where they can look after her properly.
The problem in C Block is that they play on her low intellect. They rag her about those comic book heroes of hers. There's no one strong enough to keep them in line.
But if the department insists on keeping here, there's not much we can do. See that the damage is repaired, will you?
With respect, there is one thing we can do.
Which is?
Transfer her to this block.
Well, what good would that do, just transferring the problem from one area to another?
Connors has the respect of all the women. If she told them to lay off Jones, I doubt anyone would argue.
Meaning Jones wouldn't be provoked. Could work. Thank you, Miss Ferguson. I'll think about it.
I'll get the papers ready now, if you like.
I'll think about it. Now, if there's nothing else.
Right, I'll take over now, Pat.
Oh, thanks. If Joan keeps loading these reports on me, I'll be claiming compo for RSI.
I just bumped into Egbert, literally.
Oh?
She's on laundry pickup, came bowling out of the dorms, happy as a lark. Oh, she's on top of the world now that everything's going well with she and Steve.
Oh, good for her. Poor love's had some rough breaks lately. Mm.
Reception? Yeah? Yes, I'll tell her.
That was Roger at the front gate. Mm. Apparently there's a young man here to see you. Says he's your son, Marty.
Bon voyage. He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain